My question for Paul is, besides the standard, you know, business card, flyer, and tangible items, social media, besides those, what are other ways that I can expand my business and promote my business under a pretty low salary and a pretty low price?
Okay. Excellent. Well, thanks for calling in, Emma. How long have you been open now?
I've only been open for about 4 months. This is very recent. I'm 22. You know, I'm still young. I'm just starting out, so...
Okay, excellent. Well, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. So have you created any cross promotions, like with, Furlocity? Furlocity is a local company that's kind of like Travelocity, except it's for pets and pet care. So I would look at Furlocity, and there's three other websites. I believe there's three that's a lot like Furlocity, where, pet owners will go and they'll try to find groomers, they'll try to find pet care, you know, any number of things. So I would look at those to start off with.
Okay. Do you know if those are, if you have to pay for those? I'm sure.
I think they have all different types of levels, you know, different packages where you can have the free level or you can do paid. I think that's what a lot of the sites do. And I mean, it's just depending on if you pay, whether or not you show up higher in the list. And sure. Then the next thing is too, I mean, you have a website in place too?
I'm actually working on a website right now. I'm employed. The place that I'm employed is the Albany Pet Lodge. It's actually a kennel, boarding, and daycare facility. They're located on Terminal Drive, 11 Terminal Drive in Latham. And so it's kind of like, you know, I'm attached to them. I'm my own groomer and I have my own business, but I'm also employed by them, you know, through commission. So I was thinking maybe of putting a website attached to them aside from doing my own website. Do you suggest maybe starting with just doing a website off of them and then making my own?
Well, I mean, I would do your own. What's your long-term goal? If your long-term goal is to be able to make this a full-time business where you can live off of it, then I would do your own website, because it's going to take some time for the search engine optimization to kick in. But in the meantime, while you're doing that website, I would say get a Facebook page up, and not a personal profile, but a business profile.
Right.
And start.
I do have one of those actually right now. I don't know if it's through the Facebook app where it's the business. It's a separate page, but it is attached to my Facebook page, so I can share things through my Facebook personally.
Yep.
But it is its own Facebook page, and I put promotions and, you know, I post pictures of all the dogs that I groom before and after, so kind of people can see on Facebook. I do feel Facebook is a big, you know, one of the bigger social medias for kind of the people that are looking to groom dogs. They want to see my work. They want to see if I'm any good before, you know, so photos as well. But I do have a Facebook page, so that's something I am working on. But it does cost money to promote aside from people that you have as friends. So it is a little costly, but I am doing that as well. So that's something I'm...
Yeah, and I would spend more time on that Facebook page than I would on your website, to be honest. Because think about your website. You build a website. Now the goal is, how do we get people to your website? How do you get traffic to it? And that's a lot of work. So, I mean, I have an analogy. So think about the analogy this way, that if you go by a mall and there's really nobody in the parking lot of the mall, are you going to stop by? Chances are, no. So if you go by a mall that has a lot of cars in the parking lot, you're going to stop by. And that's the way I consider Facebook to be, that there's a lot of traffic already there. So part of your Facebook strategy to grow this business should be go and find additional groups. I mean, like the 518 Entrepreneurs and the Capital Region. And so become part of all these various groups, and don't forget the local, you know, all the ASPCA chapters and the, because, you know, when an individual or a couple is looking for somewhere to keep their dog, I mean, I'm just going to put a guess out there, but I would say that they would probably call the ASPCA or, you know, one of the local, what's the word I'm looking for, Samantha, where you go and you adopt the dogs?
Local adoption agencies.
Yeah, the adoption agencies.
Yeah.
There you go. So I would friend them on Facebook and let them know. So create some cross promotion, because the whole idea is to create that word of mouth advertising.
And two things you can do there too is pet stores that don't have their own grooming business, work with them and create either a referral program or another type of opportunity where, like Paul saying, you can cross promote one another. The additional thing there too, where Paul was mentioning your Facebook page, have you done anything to request reviews from customers of yours?
I've had just friends that have come to me, you know, like good friends that have wrote reviews. I mean, I hope I did do a good job when they say I did a good job, but you know, just kind of like 5 stars, 4 stars for friends, but I haven't had any real like strangers that have come in and then haven't really done more of that. But I know word of mouth is like the biggest way to promote your business. So I know that's definitely a big part.
Yeah, so. And I would spend some time and go around and go to the different chambers of commerce, you know, the Capital Region, Schenectady right. one, the Saratoga one, and just go in and meet those individuals because they definitely come in contact with a lot of people, and that's going to help you with the word of mouth. And then, you know, you could even, I would go and do some of their meetings too and see if it makes sense.
And also ask your customers for referrals. People who own pets know other people who own pets but may not think to make the recommendation to come to you as a groomer. So you want to also make the ask.
And then here's the final thing that we want you to do too. Okay. So everyone you come in contact with, I want you to make sure you get their email address and get their mobile number and keep up with that information and start sending emails out to these individuals, just letting them know that you're in business and that you appreciate their business and if there's anything you can do, but you know that your business is based off of referrals. But make sure, you know, if you're not keeping that database, you're having to do a lot of work. And don't forget, you know, LinkedIn's a good tool to use also.
LinkedIn. Okay. Yeah, I've heard of LinkedIn. I haven't set one up yet. I know it does cost money, but I've heard it's been really, really good for a lot of business. So I will definitely look into that. Absolutely.
Well, thank you, Emma, for calling. And unfortunately, we are out of time. But thanks for your call and good luck with your business.
Thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate it. Thanks again.
Thank you,
Emma. Have a great day, okay?
You too.